Hello everyone, welcome to Mama Says. I'm Simone and this is another episode in our Christmas series. I hope you've been watching all the Christmas videos we've been putting out for you. And if you haven't watched them yet, go now. Well, coming back to today's episode, we're gonna do DIY activities for toddlers. Basically, how to keep these goldfish toddlers busy through the holidays. It's a dreaded question for parents. Parents never know what to do. Kids get bored of toys all the time. They need new things to do. Their attention span is zero. Okay, that's exaggeration, but you know what I'm talking about, Mama. So, we're gonna show you how we've kept Zephyr busy for the past couple of weeks and how we're gonna continue to keep him busy through the holidays. Stay tuned. So we're gonna start with our first DIY activity. Now, moms, don't be afraid of DIY. I know it sounds scary and everything needs to look perfect and Pinteresty. It doesn't. Keep it real, keep it simple. Use the materials that you have at home. Improvise on the stuff I'm doing based on what's easily accessible to you in your house. And don't stress, all we're doing here is creating a little fun activity for our kids to do and keep them busy for the couple of weeks that they're off school. So I'm gonna start with my first activity of the day. It's the ball tree. Well, at least I call it the ball tree. I'm not really sure what it's called. Do not judge me. I am not some extremely amazing craftsman who creates the most beautiful things, but I get the job done. I keep my child entertained and that's all that matters really, right? So let's go. So here is my ball tree. Now, don't get intimidated by the size of this box or this tree, but I'm just gonna explain a little bit about what I've done. So to start with, I used a cardboard box that I had lying around, and I also happen to have a lot of craft supplies in general in my house. So I had red paper, white paper. As you can see, this is white, this is red. I didn't have enough of everything, and I didn't really wanna go out and buy stuff for this activity. I wanted to use what I had. So I cut out a triangle shape that looks like a tree. I took a coffee mug, because like, guys, I'm pretty sure all your kids have a ball pool at home, right? So to get this ball to fit through this hole, I needed a coffee mug. All coffee mugs usually are bigger, the mouth of the coffee mug is bigger than the ball. So I used the coffee mug to trace the holes on the cardboard, and I used a cutter to cut it out. Once I did that, I just mounted it on to my cardboard box, but it was still a bit flimsy and the tree wasn't staying still. So what I did, don't judge me, the back is really messy. I used just a ruler that I have at home because I'm gonna be able to take this ruler out once we're done with the activity and reuse it. So I just used this ruler to give me a little bit of kind of support at the back. So this is my ball tree. Zephyr actually really, really enjoys it because this stays right by our Christmas tree. He has a tray of balls. He picks up a ball and my aim might be bad. Woo! It was bad. So we play this game through the day and the balls get collected in the cardboard box at the back. And then we take them out, refill them, and he keeps going at it. Even when his friends come home for play dates and whatnot, they have a great time with this activity because it's not their usual toy that they're bored of or that they've seen before. It's something different, it's exciting, it's Christmas, so they're like, oh, let's go throw the balls on the Christmas tree. It's just something really, really fun to do with your kids. Try it and tell me what your kids think of it, because trust me, they're gonna love it. And more than them, you're gonna love it because it's gonna keep them occupied for a long time. So now that we're done with DIY number one, let's move on to the second activity. The second activity is what I call the pom-pom push box. Again, I'm not really sure what the actual name is, but this one works for me. So I'm not sure if you guys have these little pom-poms at home. If not, I would really suggest investing in them. They barely cost anything. You get them on Amazon. Only because pom-poms can be used for a ton of activities for toddlers. Sensory, fine motor skill, there's a bunch of stuff you can do with pom-poms, so I would definitely ask you to buy a packet of these and keep them at home. So again, don't expect the best art and craft, but like I said, we're not perfect. We're trying to keep our kids busy. I used an old shoebox that I had lying at home. You can use any box, but preferably one that opens, because the kids are gonna push their pom-poms through here and you're gonna need to collect them back out, right? So I just covered an old shoebox with white craft paper, and then I drew a tree on that box. What I also did is I kind of used different felt pens to kind of put a line around each hole. So what I did for the holes is I just took a little cutter and tried to make as tiny a hole as possible, because the whole point is to push the pom-pom in, right? So based on my pom-pom size that I had lying at home, I made my hole according to that. So let me just explain to you how this works. So what we're gonna do is, once this box is down, Zephyr gets an entire bowl of pom-poms. He has to take the purple pom-pom and ensure he puts it and pushes it through the purple hole. So it's not like it goes in easily, it's a push, right? He takes the blue pom-pom and he pushes it through the blue hole. So what this does is, it not only does it teach him colors, but it also helps the fine motor skills. It's actually a great activity, guys. It's something that they can spend a decent amount of time on a couple of times through the day without really getting bored. And it's a fun activity for both parent and child to do together. So now that we're done with our push box, I'm gonna move that aside. I'm gonna keep my pom-poms as they are, because I'm gonna show you what we're doing next. So, remember this box that I made? This one? So the kind of top flap that I had to pull off so that the balls go in, I used that flap and I carved out a triangle, like a Christmas tree shape, and just cut it out using a cutter. And I stuck it onto an old paper bag. I just ripped an old paper bag and just stuck my cardboard onto it. So this becomes our decorate your Christmas tree activity. As you've noticed, none of our activities till now are a one-time activity. This is something the kids can keep doing over and over and over again, and that's the point. Which is why, even on this tree, we're not gonna decorate our tree by sticking things on at all. Because we want to be able to do this activity maybe every day, maybe change things around, etc. So again, I've used exactly what I have at home. I had a couple of these glitter star stickers. I also have some of these smiley face stickers. I'm gonna continue using my pom-poms. And then I have some of these multicolor sequins. So what I'm gonna do with this is basically get Zephyr or his friends to sit with all these little trinkets and make their own tree. So you literally get the child to deck the halls with boughs of holly. So I would just take that, throw it in. Then I would take some balls, maybe make a line of those. Take some of the stars. So like I said, guys, I'm sticking nothing. I want to be able to take this off and use this to decorate the tree in a new way tomorrow. This is just something fun to keep the kids busy. As you can see, I'm having a really good time doing it. Some smiley faces. And then maybe some of these again. And then we can top up our tree with a star. And that's my beautiful DIY Christmas tree decoration. Use anything that you have at home, guys. Pom-poms, old stickers, little bits of, sequin, glitter, anything. Well, glitter gets a bit messy, so something a little more, something that's easier to pick up from the tree and put back in, because you don't want a glitter mess all over the place, right? The whole point here is to not make it messy. And there's my tree. So now that we're done with decorating our Christmas tree, let's move on to the next and final DIY activity of this series. It's one of my most favorite. It is called making your own snow globe. What's Christmas without a snow globe, right? Now again, guys, the point is to use what you have easily available and accessible at home. You need one of these mason jars or like a glass jar. It could be an empty pickle jar, some sauces, anything that you have that's glass and transparent works. So I've taken this because that's the size I had. Now that happens to be the lid of the jar. This happens to be an old ornament from our tree that doesn't have its string anymore. So it's something that I could use for my snow globe. So say hello to Frosty the snowman. So I've taken Frosty the snowman and stuck him onto the lid using a little bit of super glue, Fevi Quick, anything that you want. Let that dry for a little bit. This is an activity that you definitely have to monitor with the kids. Don't let them do it alone. So I filled my jar with water. As you can see, it's not up to the top. It's about a little more than 3/4 way up. Now to fill into my snow globe, anyone who knows me knows I love glitter. So here's some glitter that I had lying around. I'm sure you have glitter lying around, else a packet doesn't really cost much. So I've got something that's a little more coarse and something that's a little more fine. So what I'm gonna do, so I'm taking my coarse glitter first and just throwing it in there. Oh my God, look at that sparkle. So now that my coarser glitter is in, I'm just gonna tap in a little bit of the fine glitter. So another thing you can do is add a little bit of glycerine to the water. What that does is separates the glitter a little bit. I haven't added it, but you can if you choose to. So now is the moment. We're gonna take our snowman and turn him upside down into the mason jar. Make sure that the jar is shut nice and tight. And that is your Christmas snow globe. So now that you've seen our DIY activities, I hope you send us pictures and stories and comments when your kids do these activities over the next couple of weeks. Because we definitely want to see them having fun with all the stuff we've come up with. We can't wait to share a lot more fun videos with you. And if you have any ideas or concepts that you want to see from us, definitely write into us, share them with us, and we will ensure that we do our best to get those to you. Also, guys, if you haven't subscribed to our channel yet, do it now and click on the bell icon so that you get notified every time we put up a new video.